Hi, my name is Brad Jolly, and I'm an applications engineer here at Keysight Technologies. In this video, I will discuss using zones on the Keysight X8712 to measure battery drain of IoT devices. So in this video, we're continuing to test our DUT. We've already acquired the data here, and we've got our main graph up here. We've got some additional items down here. We've got some graphs and a table. Let me go ahead and remove those just for right now. Turn that off, and now I've got more room in the table here in the chart up the top. I can zoom in, and I can zoom in again, and I can really zoom in to whatever level of resolution I want to see like that. And if I zoom in too far, a simple double click will take me back out of here. And then, of course, I can configure this chart to make it look exactly the way I want it to look. So I'm going to click on Configure here. And I'm going to put in a title. Let's say this is my new IoT sensor device Rev 1.3. Just making something up here. I can show the legend so that I know what the different signals are. I can show a tooltip, turn that on or off. And what that does is it lets me move over here and it tells me the value of all the different signals. I can do something called shift data series, and what that does is it splits it apart and puts the RF values up here in the top, and then it puts the current waveforms down at the bottom so that they don't overlap. It's easier to see what's going on if you shift the data series. Let me go ahead and remove that, and I can also turn off the tooltip, because right now as you look at it, it's hard to tell what's RF and what is the current waveform, but when I do the shift data series, that makes it very obvious. I can configure my x-axis. Okay, so I've got my legend there. I can specify the number of decimal points. I can rotate the labels if I want to. I can turn the grid lines on or off. Okay, and then I can do a similar thing for the y-axis right here. And the y-axis, I can specify either the amps axis, which is for the current, or the dBm axis, which is for the RF. And again, I can change the labeling, specify grid lines, and so forth. Another thing I can do is down in the series, I can rename the series. So channel 1, for example, I may want to rename that and just call it total current. And then channel 2, I might want to call RF or something of that nature. And you'll notice that that is the those names are then used in the legend. And then down here, I can say smoothed current or something like that, because that's really what it is. It's giving me smooth current values. And then I can turn those on or off, so I can turn on and off individual signals. So perhaps I just want to see the smooth current and the RF. And that's kind of a typical thing that you might want to do. Now, the other thing that's interesting is down in here in this table, I can click here and go to the table, and I can grab my markers here and say I want to go from here to grab that there. And I want to go from there to there. And the reason I'm doing that is I've got now 1, 2, 3, 4 full cycles of the current waveform. And that's good enough that I can get some statistics now. So let me go ahead and say my battery capacity is 0.240. So that's 240 milliamp hours there. And then I can go ahead and click Analyze, and it will analyze all the data between those markers there, okay? And it will tell me the maximum current between the markers, the average current, the cycle time, in other words, how long it took to get from this marker to this marker. Then it will give me the total charge, and then it will divide the total battery capacity by the charge consumed and estimate the battery life. And so that's the purpose of that table there. So I think you'll see that it's very quick to get good estimates of the battery life and to use this table and configure it to make it exactly the way you want it to look. Thank you for watching.